Hello my dear students, again, I hope all of you are fine. Today we have two topics, so please you need to listen to me carefully. Merhaba sevgili öğrenciler, bugün iki tane, umarım hepiniz iyisinizdir. Bugün iki tane konumuz var. Konularımızdan bir tanesi bu şu o. These, they, those. The second topic is plural. Plural forms of the nouns, okay? The first topic is in Turkish bu şu o. The second one is çoğul isimler. I will start the first one. Bu şu o. What does they mean? Bu means this. Close location. Bu. Şu a bit far. That. Those is the far. The most far. Farthest. O. Bu, şu, o. For example, I give you an example. Bu ne? Bu tahta kalemi. Bu tahta kalemi. I am putting this here. So, bu kalem. Now I will be a bit far. Şu, şu kalem. Now here, o kalem. According to distance, we are going to use this structure. Bu, şu, o. What about this flower? What is it? This is a flower. In Turkish, çiçek. Bu, çiçek. Now we are coming here, a bit far. Şu, çiçek. Now we are going here. O çiçek. You see, according to distance, we are going to use these forms. Bu çiçek, şu çiçek, o çiçek. Okay. If you see your book, page 39, we have some examples. Bu kalem, şu kalem, o kalem. We can increase our examples. Okay? For example, what is this? This is a ball. Ball top. Bu ne? Bu top. Bu top. Here. Şu top. Evet, far. Now I am here. O top. Bu top. Şu top. O top. Okay. Now I am giving you other example. What is this? This is a book. Bu ne? Bu kitap. Bu kitap. What about here? Şu kitap. Şu kitap. This one. O kitap. Bu kitap. Şu kitap. O kitap. Bu çiçek. Şu çiçek. O çiçek. Bu top. This ball. That ball. Şu top. Those ball. O top. Okay? These are according to distance. So, I will give you some exercise you are going to do at your home. I will write and you are going to copy to your notebook as a homework. For the first topic, I give you 5 sentences. six sentences can be okay. Bir, iki, üç, dört, beş ve altı. Highlight, defter, here for example, silgi, ağaç, çanta, okul, masa. Here what you are going to do, complete the sentences, fill in the blanks, beat, who, should, or put the appropriate form in these places. You can understand the distance by looking at arrows. Okay? What does it mean? Defter means notebook. Silgi, what is this? Bu silgi. Eraser. Ağaç, tree. Çanta, bag. Okul is school, our building. Masa, what is this? Table. You just put who should fall according to distance. Okay, this is your homework for this topic. Now I am passing to other topic, the second topic. Plural. Plural forms of the noun. What does it mean plural? For example, I have one eraser. Benim bir silgim var. Now I have added one more. So I have two now. It means this is plural. I am giving example. Take it. Çoğul. Take it is the singular form. Çoğul is the plural. Silgi. Silgi. One. Now, I have two, so it means it's a plural. Silgiler. Now it is plural. For the plural forms, we have two affixes. Ler or lar. We can use this according to the harmony of the words. For example, here, our words with end with E. So we are going to use ler. Okay? I am giving you another example. Masa. What does it mean, masa? Masa is the table. So it ends with which letter? A. So we are going to use lar for making the plural forms of the nouns. Masa, lar. Okay? Because of A, we are going to use lar. One table, masa. More than one, masalar. Tables, erasers. Okay? I am giving you another example. Silgiler. The third one. Çanta. What does it mean, çanta? Bag. Plural form. Çantalar. Again, we have A here at the end of the word. So we are going to use lar. Çantalar. Öğretmen. What does it mean, öğretmen? Me. Ben bir öğretmenim. There is one teacher. Öğretmen is the singular one. Now I am adding more. Öğretmenler. Again, we need to use ler. Why? Because we have a. For the harmony of the words, we are going to choose ler or ler. We can't say that öğretmenler, no, öğretmenler, am a teacher. Öğretmen. You are student. Öğrenci. Öğrenciler. Student. Students. Çocuk. What does it mean çocuk? Çocuk is the child. Çocuk. Now I need to write children. Çocuklar. Again, we have U here, so we need to use lar. We can't say that çocuklar. No, it is not correct. Çocuklar. Pencere. What does it mean, pencere? Pencere is the window. Is the singular one. Now is the plural. Pencereler. Again, you see we have a here. It ends with a. So we are going to use ler for making the plural form of the word. I am repeating. Silgi is the singular. Silgiler plural. Masa, masalar. Çanta, çantalar. Öğretmen, like me, one. But more, öğretmenler. Öğrenci, öğrenciler. Çocuk, çocuklar. Pencere, pencereler. Okay? I want to give you many examples, but I don't have enough space. Just so you need to understand the logic. What is the logic? We should choose ler or lar according to the verb that we have. Also for that one, I'm going to write one rule in a table. You should learn the rule. If you know the rule, you can do easily. Okay? Okay, look at here. Öğretmen ends with kütüphaneler, teachers, students and libraries, kütüphaneler, öğrenciler ve öğretmenler. Okay, this is the rule, this is the rule. Don't forget this. If you know this, you can do any type of example without problem. So, now I will write some words. I want to put in a correct form. You should write clear, singular or plural forms of the words. I am giving you homework. Peki, çoğul. Sometimes I will give you the singular one, or for some of them I will give you plural one. You should find out the correct one. Çanta. You should write its plural form here. What is it? The second one. Kalem. How we are going to make the plural form? The third one. I am giving the plural forms. You are going to find out the singular one. Sıralar. How is it like here? How is the singular form of the sıralar? Again. Which one? For example, tahtalar. You are going to find out singular form of the tahtalar. Okay, how is it like? Çanta is the bag, kalem is the pencil, sıra is the desk, desks the plural form, tahtalar boards. Okay, now I am adding kitaplar. Kitaplar. How is it singular form of the kitaplar? Find out and write here. Also, silgi. How you can make it plural? Okay? Please complete the missing parts after you watch the video. This is your the second homework. Homework. Ev, ödevi. I am repeating again, for the plural we have two affix, ler or lar. According to the table, if our verb ends with any of these letters, like a, ı, o, u, we are going to use lar for making the nouns in a plural form, like in masa, masalar, kapı, kapılar, çocuk, çocuklar. If our verb ends with e, i, ö, or ü, we are going to use ler for making the nouns plural form. Öğretmenler, öğrenciler, kütüphaneler. So according to this table, you are going to complete word. Here you should write their singular form. Here you should find out the plural form of the nouns that we have here. If you do not understand the subject, please watch my video several times. Also, you can check your books. We have some example. You can demand information from your book. Also, you can complete this verse here in page 40. 40 is the latest homework. In your lesson book, ders kitabı. Okay? Do also here. We have just only six sentences. You are going to complete the verse. Okay? For today, our topics have finished. I thank you, all of you. Take care of yourself. See you tomorrow. Görüşmek üzere. Güle güle.